What's up, sons? It's Blind Rod with Son of a Tech once again, and today I'm going to go over how to replace the fans on the MSI RX 5600 XT Mech Overclock Edition. Now, of course, the 5700 XT Edition is pretty much the same across the board. It's just that in this particular case, it has a single 8-pin power adapter. Everything else is identical as far as the cooler goes, which is also why the cooling performance on the 5700 XT in particular was much worse than the 5600 XT, which already isn't that great, but we're also going to resolve that with pads and paste while we get into it right after a word from our sponsor. Today's sponsor is Crypto.com. Crypto.com is my go-to centralized exchange for liquidating my crypto assets. With their Crypto.com Visa debit card, I can load up my mined Ethereum to pay for power and other operating costs quickly while earning up to 8% cash back. In addition to the Visa debit card, there are additional fiat options, including wire transfers, to easily receive your profits. Crypto.com also offers additional services, including trading and even staking, to earn additional revenue on your investments. Join 10 million plus users buying and selling 100 plus cryptocurrencies at true cost by using my affiliate link in the description for a $25 funding bonus, or enter referral code SOAT at sign up for the same bonus. Remember, cryptocurrency investment comes with significant risks, so do your own research. Welcome back. So if you guys are not familiar with the channel, it's always the pad, bro, unless you don't have a fan spinning, and then it's probably the fan. Now, if you're mining on these GPUs 24/7, it's inevitable that fans are going to go out. There's a couple different options here, of course, and one of them is going to be just ripping the fan shroud off, which we'll be going over how to take the fan shroud off, and zip tying some regular 120 millimeter fans to the cooler and then just get it up and running again. Or of course doing something like liquid immersion, which is going to be a much larger scale of getting something done, because you'll need to get the bins and the liquid and all of that and work out all your plumbing. Bitsby Trippin is actually working on that right now, so go check his channel out if you want to see what he's doing with his mining farm as far as that goes. Or finally, of course, you do have the option of just replacing it with the stock fans, which is what we're doing here. The reason this is something that you may want to consider is for resaleability. Obviously, trying to resell a GPU with some, you know, rigged up 120 millimeter fans zip tied to the cooler isn't going to be ideal. So no matter what, at some point, you probably want to make sure you keep your fan and fan shrouds, or at least the fan shroud itself, so that you can put the original stock fans back on for resaleability. So today, all you're really going to need is going to be the fan replacements, which for these models you can get on Amazon.com. I'll leave affiliate links down below. An affiliate link means that I get a kickback if you do make a purchase of one of the links. You'll need a toolkit. I use the iFixit toolkit just because it has all the bits and everything. It's super nice and convenient, and it was a Christmas present for my mother-in-law, which makes it all that much better. And then, of course, you do want all of new pads, new thermal pads. In this case, because I have been moving towards more expensive thermal pads, they're not needed on this one, to be frank. You can get away with the little blue ones, but we do have the G-Lid GC Extreme 2 millimeter pads, and then we have the cheap blue ones for the 1.5 millimeter pad that goes on the back of the card, which we'll show you here when we get into the breakdown. And then some thermal paste. In this case, it's going to be the G-Lid GC Extreme paste, and that is going to be what the results reflect, right? So then at that point, what are we looking at as far as before? We went ahead and threw it on the test bench and ran it for about 20 minutes on just LOL miner mining Ethereum, and the memory was hitting 104 degrees Celsius while the core was hitting 74 degrees Celsius. Now, in this particular case, because we have one fan working and it's primarily over the core as well as the memory modules, just right over it, it's not that bad. I know 104C sounds like a lot, but it's not thermal throttling yet. Remember, you got till 110C in most cases on most new GPUs until that memory starts thermal throttling. We were getting full hash rate and we were perfectly fine. But I don't want to have a fan out, so we went ahead and got to work on replacing it. Plus, I get to do a tutorial video on that. So now that you have all the tools ready to go, you will want to go ahead and break out your iFixit toolkit or just a small screwdriver and undo the four screws on the back that hold the cooler to the PCB or to the board. And there's going to be four of them. You'll crack each one loose, and then I like to undo them evenly in a star pattern. The reason for this is to make sure that I don't put any uneven pressure on the die itself or on the core. And then once that's removed, you can basically pry it apart. In a lot of cases, you will have pretty sticky thermal pads and thermal paste, so it may take a little bit of force, but be careful. Now, of course, all four of these screws are undone, and I have done it so I can tell you which four they are. However, in the case that it does feel like something is holding it back or you're working on a different GPU, make sure you look around for more screws before you continue. Also, this in certain regions will void the warranty, so a fair warning there. In the US, we do have right to repair. However, you know, that's kind of a hard to prove in a lot of cases, and don't really want to be going to court over a $300 graphics card, so just keep that in mind. Now, once you have that pulled apart, you're going to want to undo the fan header, and once the fan header is undone, we can get to work on taking the heatsink off of the fan shroud, or vice versa. There's going to be four black screws on the side of the cooler, and you'll just want to basically undo all four of those, and then the fan shroud will come off of the actual cooler itself. And then at that point, you can remove the fans. Each fan has three screws. You will have to get through them from the top side. So basically with the fans facing upwards towards you, there'll be three screws, and you'll kind of have to spin the fan blades around. There is more of a gap between every other fan blade, so try to find the one with more of a gap and then go in and undo all three of those. You'll have to undo the wiring and then basically unplug the two fans from each other and then feed the wires through the fan shroud to remove the old fans. Basically do this in reverse order to install the new fans, feeding the wires through, making sure that you cable manage them and plug them into each other. And then, of course, take the cooler or the fan shroud and put it back onto the heatsink and reassemble the cooler by putting the four screws back in. If you do forget in which manner it goes in, don't worry, it only goes back one way, so you should be good to go as far as that is concerned. Finally, you're going to want to clean off any old thermal paste and thermal pads from the cooler as well as from the board itself, and apply new pads to the board and new paste to the board. Just making sure you cut to size and then lay it over, making sure to remember to remove the film from both sides of the thermal pads once complete. That's always an important thing. If later you have high temperatures, more than likely you probably left a little film on one of the memory modules. Next, all you got to do is plug the fan or the fan shroud and everything back into the board and then just place it back onto the cooler itself and then screw the four screws in a star pattern to make sure you don't apply uneven pressure to the chip itself. Once you're done there, you can plug it on up into, of course, your test bench or back into your mining rig and check the temperatures. In my case, like we said, before we had done this, we were doing 104C on the memory and 74C max on the chip itself. We dropped 3 degrees on the chip itself, on the core, going down to 71 degrees Celsius, and we dropped all the way down to 86 degrees Celsius on the memory. Like I said, in this particular case, there is probably no reason at all to have the GLID GC Extreme 15 watt pads on there. It dropped it, you know, almost 20 degrees at this point, which is insane. It's actually 18 degrees Celsius drop. Of course, we do have the fan that got added onto there, which is going to help. And then basically the best pads on the market. Now keep in mind, these pads do disintegrate a little bit quicker than your traditional pads. And that is because they also have a much higher thermal dissipation rate. So you will need to replace them a little bit more often. I can't tell you exactly how much that will be. Your mileage will vary depending on the GPU, the conditions in which the GPU is running or mining or gaming in, and so on. So just keep that all in mind. You can check down in the description below for all the affiliate links. Thanks everybody for the support as of late. I'm feeling a little bit better today. I'm feeling a little bit better today. Still under the weather, but hopefully we'll be back and running full strength here coming up this week. And I will see you next Tuesday. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe to see more. Also, you can check out this playlist for more content talking about cryptocurrency.